Hey guys, you're watching Halborn Flash Videos. I'm your host, Arabdha, and today we've got Radu from Bware Labs joining us in for this chat. So welcome to this conversation, Radu, and introduce yourself a little bit to our audience.
Thank you for having me, first of all. I'm super excited to be here today. My name is Radu Enoiu. I am one of the co-founders of Bware Labs. I'm currently in charge of the product development and research within the Bware Labs company. My background is mainly in software engineering and product management with over 10 years of experience in software, mostly in traditional big tech companies such as Google, Fitbit or Oracle, and then working as a product manager in a couple of crypto startups before I found my other four co-founders and started Bware Labs.
Awesome. So you're actually a co-founder, and hence I have to ask you, how did you guys come together and start Bware, and what major industry problem were you aiming to solve with that?
Well, me and Flaviano are actually university colleagues. We used to be in the same class during university. And then he was the one that introduced me to crypto. We worked together at one of our current competitors, actually. And while we were there, the other three guys were hired by me and Flavian to help us with the blockchain integrations at that time. So the five of us, we were always working and integrating new chain into a cloud platform. And at some point, we noticed that it's too commonly accepted for the Web3 space to have failing products, to have to try to do an operation multiple times, or to have UIs that get stuck and stuff like that. And a big chunk of these outages were actually due to infrastructure and bad developer tooling. At some point, there was even an INFRA crash around somewhere in 2020, and it caused even Binance not to have withdrawal available for the customer. So we thought, okay, infrastructure can be done better than that. Let's try to bring some true reliability and performance into the space. And then we came with the idea of building Blast, which is a decentralized RPC platform, trying to solve for all the problems that I mentioned before.
So tell us a bit more about Bware. We would love to learn, like, what is the key feature? What does the platform entail, and what exactly does it handle?
Yeah, although it started with the idea of providing a decentralized API platform, right now we see Bware Labs as more of an all-encompassing infrastructure and developer tooling platform. If you want a one-stop shop for boosting blockchain ecosystem adoption. What we're trying to do, as I said earlier, is bring real reliability and high performance to the Web3 space, and basically support developers throughout the entire development life cycles, from development to production release and beyond. And we are building tools and services that come in support of developers. And this includes from blockchain APIs to faucets, explorers, indexing, SDKs, and whatnot. So there's a whole range of services that we are currently providing in support of both blockchains that want to increase their adoption, but developers as well that are building on the blockchains that we support.
Got it. So definitely a lot of the dev crowd is very thankful and very active with Bware. So Blast looks like a super interesting product, right? So tell us a little bit more about it and what makes it so unique.
We try to create an entire concept around it, because we were looking at the Web3 infrastructure provider or blockchain API providers, and we noticed that there was a pattern. They were all centralized. So it was very funny in a way that even though blockchains strive for decentralization, the very access to the blockchain is fully centralized. But then it came with another problem, because when companies have to choose between performance and decentralization, they will always choose performance. And this is not trying to compare ourselves in any way, but it is basically, in my opinion, a similar story that you have with Tesla. Tesla is not only the most advanced technological electrical car, but what they did actually, well, they came with the idea that an electrical car that is very useful for Earth and for climate change can be also sexy and faster than a traditional car. So in Blast, we try to show that you can have a decentralized provider, a decentralized platform that is faster than a centralized provider and more reliable. So that was the mission. This is the mission we started with. We try to make a platform that is both decentralized and faster than a centralized provider. We are actually there. According to our benchmark and a couple of third-party sites that benchmark providers, Blast is, if not first, always in top three providers, even after we launch our mainnet and we are decentralized at the moment. So we are very happy to have been achieved that.
Yeah, congrats. That top three consistently definitely looks like massive adoption on Blast. So that's always great to hear, right? And Infra is the utility token that powers Blast. So talk to us a bit more about it. I know that the rollout is coming in very soon as well. So it would be great to know a little bit more about that.
Yeah, actually, the token will be going live on May 30th. So Infra is a utility token with the purpose of providing the necessary incentives for operators to join the Blast protocol and allow us to decentralize support for all the 24 networks that we are currently hosting in the platform. So let me explain a little bit about how the process works. Basically, in order to join Blast as a node operator, you don't have to run any custom code on your full node or archive node. You just register your endpoint into the platform and you undergo an onboarding set of checks. Now, provided the node matches the performance and security criteria required by Blast, it becomes active. And in order for a node operator to be also incentivized for that node, they have to create a staking pool, stake a minimum of 5,000 tokens, and based on their performance, they will receive an APY. Moreover, each created staking pool in Blast can receive delegations from outside Infra token holders to basically increase their income. On the other hand, any token holder, people that buy Infra or hold Infra, can delegate their token to any of the operators. They have the opportunity to see the performance of the operator and the commission, similar to how it's done with actual blockchains. And the Delegation Explorer is very easy to use. You just connect your MetaMask, you select an operator, and you delegate a couple of clicks, and it will be available on the listing day, basically on May 30th. Now, to summarize, Infra provides the incentive model for all Blast participants, both node operators and delegators. And it is also used to encourage the performance on the part of node providers, since the earnings of each provider is directly proportional to their performance. And on the other hand, nodes can also be jailed if they are out of sync, if they serve bad data or have low latency, and for the jail period they receive no rewards. So if you want to get high rewards and get a steady income, you have to make sure that your node keeps the required level of performance.
Well, that seems like a very incentivizing algorithm for the community to hold and friend take more participation in the ecosystem. So looking forward to May 30th. And you guys also have like strong industry partnerships in place, right? So you've got Avalanche, Polygon, Multiverse X, and Sui. Talk to us a bit more about how these partnerships support your mission right now.
Basically, this was not a well-thought strategy since the beginning. It was mostly lucky that we got to work with all these projects. Initially, we were trying to do some sort of due diligence on what projects we want to support in Blast. Once we launch it, we would join as validators during testnet. We would play around with their technology and then get in contact with each blockchain to see if they would be interested to be added in Blast or if there's any way we can help. So doing that and paying a lot of attention to what were the actual needs during testnets or in the communities led to higher collaboration opportunities. For example, with Polygon, at some point they needed help for someone to host their public API. And we were willing to do that. And so we started the partnership, which then evolved into us adding support for Polygon in Blast. having a validator on Polygon. Now we have also support for Polygon ZK EVM, and we're also an integration partner for Polygon Supernets. And it worked the same with each and every other blockchain. For example, in the case of Aptos, because that's why I mentioned it, is we were one of their initial validators, aside from having support in Blast and building a snapshot service for them. And we noticed that it was very hard to accept delegations because there was no delegation mechanism in the Aptos ecosystem. You had to hold 1 million APT to create, to become an operator. And that was a very high barrier. So we thought, why not build one? And then we talked with the team, we showed them our solution. They thought this was very elegant, and they proposed for us to integrate it into the actual core framework of Aptos. So we have basically built the delegated staking functionality in the Aptos ecosystem. It was released about 1 month ago. This is how we try to get close to an ecosystem that we believe in and then support its adoption. Basically, that's the way it works.
All right, it's great to see how you have kind of interacted with YouTube ecosystem before building the partnership on it as well. So we are talking about a lot of security work together. So talk to us a bit about your overall security strategy and why go with Halborn.
Well, as I was saying earlier, the main purpose of Blast is to provide a reliable alternative for blockchain access. And we think this is very important to achieve. This is also about trust. And then security is directly tied into trust. We wanted to make sure that nothing can happen to our protocol participants, whether they're operators or delegators. And we were looking to work with the best teams in industry because this was actually not a place where you want to do any trade-offs. So in our opinion, Halborn was the most reputable one that we knew. And we also had some work with you guys beforehand. So we thought that this should be the way to go here. So we make sure that everything is prepared for the launch and for the protocol to thrive beyond that. So that's why we chose Halborn. And these were the criteria.
Thank you so much for the vote of trust as well. And I have to ask you, what's next coming up for Bware? Anything that you want to let the community know about?
Well, we have multiple initiatives that we're working on, both on the validator side, on the ecosystem enhancement side. We are having a couple of collaborations that will be coming up in the next months. And then for Blast, there are a couple of very exciting things that are going to happen in the future. Just in Q3, we will release some new functionalities related to historical data. And we are currently designing a new pricing model that we believe it will have the a chance to disrupt the entire industry in the way that we are seeing it. So basically, we are trying to unlock the power of decentralization and reduce costs to provide our customers with a better pricing model that will not be just paying for compute units. So this is coming up in Q3. We are very excited about it. It's still in testing. It's going to be a pilot program and then hopefully a release to the larger audience.
All right, great. So we're looking forward to Q3 and all those updates that you mentioned. Thank you so much, Radu, for taking the time to talk to us today and looking forward to all the updates from Bware. Thanks again.
Thank you for having me. It was a very big pleasure to be here.